Hey guys, Captain Smash, Smash the Strength Lab, Ottawa, Ontario. So today we're talking about getting to your fitness goals and making sure your goals are realistic. So this is a big problem I see in a lot of people that come in, and you know, I sit down with them, we do the assessment, we kind of figure out what their goals are. You know, generally it revolves around something like, I want to move better, I want to feel better, I want to lose fat, I want to look awesome in the mirror naked, that type of thing. So, but really, when you're separating that out for a client and they're starting at one point and then they want to go to point B or C, wherever that point is, you have to kind of relate to that person. Okay, well, you know, you're about 20, 30, 40 pounds overweight and you want to look like a fitness model. And, whoa, okay. So, you know, the initial phase, there's nothing that changes. You know, you start training, you start improving upon the diet, and things start flowing along very naturally in that pattern. However, the higher up you go on the level of fitness, so like say I want to be an elite CrossFit athlete, I want to be a figure model or a physique competitor on a bodybuilding show, the level at which those people have to sacrifice for their lives is immense. All right, so I mean we're talking about a complete 180 in lifestyle. You know, we're talking about, you know, all overall nutrition changes, sleep changes, possibly even work changes. For a lot of people, that's just not feasible for them. So whenever we take somebody in, we always try to relate to that client. Okay, where do you want to go? How close or how much are you willing to sacrifice to get to that goal? Because that's really what's going to separate your training program out from the rest. We only have so much time and physical effort that we can commit to during the day. Many people have families, they have jobs, very important career patterns. You know, their time is limited. So in order to take somebody that's, you know, far out of shape and, you know, hasn't been training for any length of time and turn them into a physique or fitness model, it's gonna take, number one, a long time, and it's also gonna take a lot of habit forming to get them to that level, because they're not used to that level of intensity. You can't just throw them into, you know, a 6 day a week program and expect them to have good results. It's just not gonna happen. So generally what I try to do with those people that have these very lofty goals is set them up for success by making some short-term goals, you know, inform them that, you know what, this process is a long process and you're gonna have to do a lot of changes and a lot of lifestyle modifications in order to get there. Because the people you see in the magazines, the people that are doing this for a living, like myself, we've devoted our lives to fitness and nutrition, and how far you want to go down that rabbit hole really depends on you. Not to say that you can't do it, but if you're starting from zero and you want to be a hero, it's going to take a while. It's going to take at least a year for you to get at least some of the basic skills, the basic nutrition patterns figured out, you know, and feeling good. We want to be able to feel good while we're doing this whole process until we get to that point where we're at an elite level of competitiveness. So it's a process. It's a long process to get to point A to point B. And, you know, just letting people know, hey, look, you know, we can get there, but it's going to take a while, depending on your goals. Now, if you're just after, you know, hey, I want to look better, I want to move better, I want to feel better, that stuff's easy. You know, that stuff comes with, like, you know, training 2 or 3 times a week. Boom, done. Okay, that's all you really need to have, you know, a fairly successful weight loss journey and, you know, look a little bit better, feel a little bit better, and move. That's it, you know. 2 to 3 times a week of hard training is perfect for that person. But if you have more lofty goals and you want to be an advanced level competitor, or you want to look like the girl or guy in the magazines, you're going to have to sacrifice a lot. And that's not something that's often talked about in, you know, common social media these days. It's like, you know, the people that are posting and they got the great blogs with, you know, their fitness endeavors and, you know, the bodybuilding shows and physique shows and the triathletes and whatnot, they've devoted their lives to doing that thing. It would be counterproductive to say that you could do it in under a year for that. So I guess all I'm trying to say is, like, look at the quality of your goals and how lofty they are. Like, where are they set? Like, you know, you can always shoot for the stars, but make sure you have stepping stones for success along the way. And if you find yourself going, you know what, this just really isn't for me, find a happy medium ground, okay? There's always that medium ground that people feel really well, they're able to move around, they're able to do the things they want to do, and they can still feel and perform like an athlete. So, anyway, just speaking my mind on some things, and I hope you like this video. If you liked it, give it a like, and if you think somebody else might like this, see it, give it a share. All right, chat with you soon.